Okay, I got this image that I scanned in for a restoration project, and I don't know how you are about scanning, but I almost never get the picture in the scanner, you know, aligned straight. And this is a little tip about straightening up stuff. And as you can see, the scanner scanned it in upside down. So the first thing I want to do is unlock the background here. You can hold down the Option key and double click on that, and it'll just automatically set that up as a layer. Then we can go to image rotation, then 180 degrees. This is a little bit off angle, as you can see, and you can use the transform tools, Command T, like this, and just click right there around an edge here, and you can try to eyeball it if you want to, but there's actually an easier way to do this. Let's just set that up. Hiding behind the eyedropper tool, if you click and hold, is the ruler tool. And you can get to it with Shift I. You just shift, keep typing I until you get to it. Now all you have to do is pick a line. And we'll start with the edge of the original image. So I'm going to click up here. And I'm going to drag down and just line it up real carefully here. And then go to image rotation, and pick arbitrary. And here in this little dialog, already has set up the angle to correct to the nearest perpendicular and the direction. And click OK, and you are vertical. Unfortunately for this picture, there are distortions. Some lens distortion here, and you get off angles and stuff like that. Well, let's check this out. Click here, and then down here on the white border, and then image rotation arbitrary. Okay, anyway, that's a nice little tip on how to rotate. Let's go back to the eyedropper tool, and the ruler disappears. Okay, since we're here, let's try and clean this up a little bit. Let's hold down the Option key, click and drag up to duplicate the layer. And let's just turn this off for right now. And let's do a little bit of levels. You can see how shallow the image data depth is on this image. So I'll just pull this in here, pull this in here. And I want to go a little lighter. So I got a little bump right there. I'll just pull it into there. Okay. I'm gonna put those together. Hold down the Shift key and select both of those. Duplicate that. Merge them. And take that off here. Now I use this for my base image. Well, let's try this real quick. Let's go over to channels, and let's pick one. Yeah, it's kind of flat. It's got a lot of noise in it. I'm going to pick this one. Hold down the Command key and click on the icon. Let's duplicate this again and throw on a mask. Let's see what we got. If we hold down the Option key and click on the mask, we can get just what the mask looks like, and Command L for levels, and let's just adjust this a little bit. Okay. Let's duplicate this layer and invert the mask. Command I to invert it. Now we have these two layers with opposite masks. And I'm going to put this against the original. Let's start with this one. And double click here. Call up the layer styles. Start with a drop shadow. Let's go with hard light, 100%. And we'll start there. Okay. And that's not too bad. Let's bring it up a little bit. Let's try this one. Pulling up a little bit more detail here. Let's try and throw levels on here. Okay, let's select all of these. Hold down the Option key, click and drag up. Merge them together, Command E. Desaturate this. Command Shift U and go to Surface Blur. I'm holding down the Command key and clicking on this number and dragging right or left to change the number right now. I guess about there. Okay. Select overlay. Let's see what this is against the original. You can tell he's actually wearing glasses here now. And he has a beard and a mustache. We're never going to get that much out of this, so this is about the best we're going to get. Okay. Add a hue saturation lightness. Take the saturation down a little bit. There we go.